SeXXXy Eddy, man.
SeXXXy Eddy?
SeXXXy Eddy, that's his name. SeXXXy Eddy. And I know SeXXXy Eddy very well. I've teamed with him, fought with him, fought against him. Eddy and I, we've been up and down the roads together. We don't always see eye to eye, but I respect the man. He's very accomplished. He's recently been overseas in Japan, wrestling over there at the DDT promotion. And tonight, he's got one of the biggest challenges of his career facing him, as he will be taking on none other than a man you know very well, your brother from another mother, Black Machismo, Jay Lethal.
And I want to tell you about that. My brother approved of Jay Lethal 100% and even sent him word, thank you for keeping his memory alive. And he loved the imitation.
Machismo J. Lethal.
Well, he reminds me of somebody, and
you can't quite put your finger on it.
Yeah.
He reminds me of somebody, too.
And he does it so well, doesn't he?
He absolutely does. I had the pleasure of taking him on a couple of days ago, and absolutely phenomenal. A former X Division champion, multiple-time X Division champion in TNA wrestling.
Is that right?
Multiple-time X Division champion.
That, I did not know that.
Yep, he's held the title on several occasions. And he's looking to electrify here tonight with the Mega Powers on the back of his tights. Do you remember the Mega Powers?
That is Hulk Hogan and the Macho Man. Yeah.
No, it's not. Oh, yeah, indeed. And it looks like we're going to be getting it on here. Black Machismo taking on SeXXXy Eddy. What a special treat this match is for our fans. Truly an outstanding contest here between these two. I'm told this is not the first meeting of Black Machismo, Jay Lethal, and SeXXXy Eddy. However, it's the first one-on-one meeting of the two.
SeXXXy Eddy needs to stop stalling and get in there and do some...
Well, it's a sign of insecurity, perhaps. And, you know, when it comes to insecurity, Eddy is really first and foremost in that category. I mean, the guy calls himself SeXXXy Eddy. You know, I'm the silver tongue sex symbol, but I'm Jeremy Proper. He is SeXXXy Eddy. He's the ladies' man, SeXXXy Eddy. As if it's not enough calling yourself the ladies' man.
I would like to say that I'd like to take a guess that he's probably been turned down more times than a bedsheet.
Very well said. And he still seems to want nothing to do with Lethal. This is really going against our code of ethics here in Great North Wrestling. We're about fighting. We're about combat. We're about the spirit of competition. And now this is just depriving the people of what they want to see. I don't like seeing that.
Well, he probably won't last long anyway. Because that Jay Lethal...
What happened? Did you talk to one of his exes?
No, I think Jay Lethal, once you get past the imitations, he can really go.
Oh, I know firsthand that he can really go. And right now, I think that's just a little bit of mind games just to get inside the head of Eddy. A lot of what Eddy does, though, is deception. A lot of it is mind games on his part, too. You know, coming out here, ripping off the pants, wearing the little underwears. You know, a lot of that is mind games. A lot of times I've seen Eddy win matches just based on opponents being freaked out by his actions. Tonight now, it looks like they're finally going to get down to wrestling as we see a good collar and elbow tie up there by the two competitors in this match. SeXXXy Eddy in the red. Black Machismo, Jay Lethal, the yellow with red trim as Eddy manages to back up Black Machismo. And there, Eddy trying to sneak in a shot, gets met with a jab of his own. Eddy, I can't help you. I can't help you, Eddy. I'm signed to a contract to do commentary tonight.
How's the sport going to help?
I don't know. It'll keep him moisturized. It'll keep him cool.
Hydrated.
Hydrated as well. Exfoliated. Eddy now looking a little worse for wear after that punch. You know, I once seen a show where Eddy got his tooth knocked out. He still managed to win, but said it was utterly a loss because he wasn't able to go get any girls at the after party with a tooth missing. Eddy very protective of his face, very protective of his looks, and very, very deceiving in that he may come across as a pretty boy. You'll never hear me calling him that, but Eddy can get it done in the ring too. He's been in a lot of violent matches, a lot of matches involving thumbtacks, chairs, tables, neon lights, and there's another punch right to the jaw, followed by another one, a third. Eddie's looking a little loopy, and he just took a taste of elbow. And a big body slam.
Boy, what a lot of coordination.
I think this might be a double axe handle. Big double axe handle. I saw the sweat fly off the brow of Eddy, and here's a pin. It could be over. I shouldn't be so quick to say that because Eddy is a really resilient competitor. He has an unbelievable threshold for pain. It's one thing I can't take away from him. He can take some of the biggest beatings and still keep going. It's very deceptive. Eddy, very deceptive. You look at him, he might not look like much. He has a lot of talent, and he has a lot of grit and toughness. But I think tonight he's maybe a little bit overmatched. Maybe it's the mystique of facing someone like Black Machismo here tonight with the brother of the Macho Man here on commentary with the Silver Tongue sex symbol. And that must be the 10th. That must be the 11th. That must be the 12th. He's going right around the clock with those punches. That's about 12 that Eddie's taken right to the jaw. And I don't think that'll be the last. There's another one. And I heard that one all the way here, didn't you?
Yes, I think he's hitting him so hard that my face is sore.
Oh, Eddy takes another one. I guess Eddy won't be making it to the after party tonight. Isn't it great? I don't even have to wrestle. I get to go to the after party as much fun as I want. And Eddy,
it's past my bedtime. I'm going home.
Ah. I get to go to the after party and have fun, and Eddie's going to be in a trauma unit getting his face put back together. And now Black Machismo calling for the big elbow drop. And in this day and age, nobody does it better. Headed up to the top. Much more comfortable up there than Jack the Mountie. And who's there? This goop over here. This goofball decides to interject himself into the match. I got a question how the Athletic Commission can allow someone like this doofus to have a manager's license. This is just wrong. And now Eddy taking control of the match. Leave it to Eddy to take a shortcut. And now choking him. This is just against the rules. This is uncalled for.
But he's using his leverage and he's using the rope.
And now he's using his manager too. This is why Eddy has to team with me, because he has difficulties getting it done on his own. He's got to rely on the hard work of someone else, whether it's me as a tag team partner, whether it's this guy with his backwards Yankee cap. You know, the backwards Yankee cap, yeah, he thinks it looks great. It went out of style in 1995, but of course, no one keeps up with that. And now Eddy, once again taking shortcuts, dragging the face of Jay Lethal right across that top rope.
But you know what they did in Yankee Stadium? They made a tribute to my brother when he passed. A tribute the Yankees did. He was friends with George Steinbrenner, always participated in their charity events.
That is really wonderful. I heard about that. I heard they even played his music, or they played the Macho Man song by the Village People.
That's right.
The tribute, yeah. And every time I would hear that song, as we see a big rope-assisted powerbomb there by Eddy, every time I would hear that song, I would think of Randy Savage. I, as a youngster, being that I'm much younger than yourself, would hear that song, and I would think of Randy Savage when they were saying Macho, Macho Man.
Everybody in this building is younger than myself.
Yeah, well, it happens. There's been a lot of tributes to the Macho Man. Do you know that the television show, very popular with the kids, Pokemon, actually did an episode where it was called Macho Macho Man, because Machoke is one of the Pokemon that they have, and they called it Macho Macho Man.
Right. And Family Guy had a couple of episodes with the Macho Man.
That as well, yeah. Just a huge icon in popular culture.
And the movie The Spider-Man had the Macho Man.
It did. It featured the Macho Man as well. I mean, the Macho Man's career, it spanned professional wrestling. It went into movies. It went into even rap music.
It broke out of the microcosm of just wrestling.
Absolutely.
And Slim Jim and everything.
Yeah, and this Slim Jim here on the outside just did a drive-by. In my neck of the woods, we call that a drive-by. Maybe in Jay's neck of the woods, he calls it a drive-by, too. He just did a drive-by and took a cheap shot at him. As SeXXXy Eddy may be coasting his way here to victory. Clearly showing that his dance moves are superior to his wrestling technique.
I think he's got a bruised knuckle.
And now Eddie's turning his attention to a rather portly fan in the audience. This match might turn into a handicap match if we let that man in, and I don't mean because it'll be a two-on-one.
Okay, I get it.
That's right, I said it. Now, Jay Lethal looking to put some offense together to turn this thing around. Eddie's just been on top of him, but it's been like he's been fighting two guys.
Got this one in the bank, baby. Money!
Nevertheless, Jay Lethal, very accomplished, holds a decisive pinfall victory over Kurt Angle, the Olympic gold medalist. Defeated him to win the X Division title in TNA, believe it or not. He also has a submission victory over Ric Flair, having used the figure four to defeat Ric Flair.
Now, Ric Flair is older than me.
He's older than everyone here in attendance tonight.
And I have more hair than Flair.
There's two things you have more than Ric Flair, hair and money.
Oh, man. Well, he's got more money in the negative. The big minus sign and a big red.
Well, Eddie is looking to put Jay Lethal into the negative right now with this form of a chin lock, side chancery, as you like to call it. It might be a choke at this point. I don't see the referee checking on the actual hold, but more on what the effect of it is on Jay Lethal.
You know, I'm just amazed that you used it in a sentence. A long time after I said chancery, and I must say you're a good student.
I'm a natural learner, I'm a quick learner. Everyone who's come across me in this wrestling business has said that I'm a very quick learner. There's the vicious elbows to the sternum. SeXXXy Eddy with a big line and a big flying forearm to the head of Eddy. And a clothesline. And another one. Eddie's got this bell.